He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, let's practice looking at initial rates and rate laws. Given the initial rates data below, determine the rate law and the value of the rate constant for this reaction. So the reaction we are looking at is 2NO plus Cl2 yields 2NOCl. And here is the initial rates data that we are going to use to find the rate law and the rate constant. So if this seems confusing, go ahead and check out my tutorial on kinetics. And when you're ready, give this a try. Okay, so we're going to put this reaction at the top, and then here is all of our initial rates data. Now, in order to find the rate law, we're going to have to compare two different trials and see how the data changes in terms of concentration and rate. So the first thing we want to do is compare trials 1 and 2. So we're looking at trials 1 and 2 there. Now, we first notice that the concentration of NO stays the same. 0.1 molar and then 0.1 molar. However, the concentration of Cl2 increases from 0.10 to 0.15. So that is a factor of 1.5. So for the second trial, the Cl2 concentration is a time and a half, that for trial 1. Then we look at the rate of NO consumption, and that goes from 0.003 to 0.0045. So the rate also increases by a factor of 1.5. Now, a lot of times when we're using initial rates data, we are seeing concentrations double, and that makes the arithmetic nice and tidy, but we won't always see that. It's not always so convenient. So we need a way to determine the rate law when these concentrations are not doubling, but are instead varying by some other factor. So we can use this technique. All we have to do is take the rate from trial 2 over the rate from trial 1, and that is going to be equal to the concentration of Cl2 from the second trial raised to the x power over the concentration of Cl2 from the first trial also raised to the x power. And if we solve this equation for x, we will find the order with respect to Cl2. So this side will simplify to 1.5. And then on the right, since these are raised to the same exponent, we can take 0.15 and divide by 0.10, and that will be 1.5 to the x. Now, in order for 1.5 to the x to be equal to 1.5, x must be 1. So an x value of 1 means that the reaction is first order in Cl2. So first order because x equals 1. Okay, so next, let's compare trials 1 and 3. So first, we will notice that this time the concentration of Cl2 stays the same. However, the concentration of NO increases by a factor of 1.5, again from 0.1 to 0.15. However, this time the rate increases by a different factor, and to find out what that factor is, that is going to be 0.00675 divided by 0.003, and so that is a factor of 2.25. We would have to multiply that first rate by 2.25 in order to get the second rate. So this is a little bit different. Let's use the same equation. So we've got our rate from trial 3 over the rate from trial 1, and then we have the concentrations raised to the x power. This time, those rates, that will simplify to 2.25 as we found. Here, once again, we get 1.5 to the x. However, now, in order to solve for x, we're going to have to do a little bit of algebra. It's not as simple as it was before. So what we can do is we can take the natural log of both sides. The reason that's useful is that due to some rules regarding logarithms, we can take that exponent x and bring it down as a coefficient in front of that natural log term. So now we have natural log of 2.25 equals x times the natural log of 1.5. Now to solve for x, we divide both sides by the natural log of 1.5, and then we just plug that into the calculator and we get 2. So because X equals 2, the reaction is second order in NO. So this technique is useful because we can use any kind of data where the concentrations and the rates are increasing by any factor. It doesn't even have to be an integer factor. It can be any random data. It doesn't have to be the perfect situation where things are doubling. We can take any data and we will be able to calculate the order with respect to any of these reactants. However, if that seemed a little bit confusing, there's also another way to rationalize it where we don't have to do quite as much arithmetic. We can just say that the Cl2 concentration increases by a factor of 1.5, the rate increases by a factor of 1.5, and 1.5 equals 1.5 to the 1, so it is first order in Cl2. Then we would say that the NO concentration increases by a factor of 1.5, the rate increases by a factor of 2.25, and 2.25 equals 1.5 squared. So because of that 2 right there, we know it is second order in NO. So in other words, if the rate increases by a factor that is equivalent to the factor by which the concentration increases, that is first order. If the concentration increases by some factor and the rate increases by that factor squared, that is second order. If the concentration were to increase by some factor and the rate were to increase by that factor cubed, that would be third order. So we're beginning to see the arithmetic relationship here, and we can probably apply this to really any situation with initial rates, not just the oversimplified ones. So now that we know that the reaction is second order with respect to NO and first order with respect to Cl2, we can find this rate law. And the rate law is going to be as follows. The rate equals K times the concentration of NO squared, because it is second order with respect to NO, times the concentration of Cl2 with no exponent because it is first order with respect to Cl2. Now, it is very important to note that any correlation with stoichiometric coefficients is coincidental. It is true that NO is raised to the second power and it has a coefficient of 2, and Cl2 is not raised to any power and it has a coefficient of 1. So those do correspond to the stoichiometric coefficients in the balanced equation, but that is coincidental. It is not the case that those coefficients become the exponents in the rate law, and you will see many examples where they do not correlate. So we must remember that is purely coincidental. So now we want to solve for the rate constant, K. Now that is going to be very easy. So first let's solve for K in the rate law. And to do that, we just divide by those concentrations. So the rate constant is going to be equal to the rate divided by NO concentration squared times Cl2 concentration. And now in order to solve for that rate constant, we can just use the data from any trial we wish. So let's just arbitrarily choose trial 1, and we just plug everything in. So K is equal to the rate, or 0.00300 molar per second, divided by NO concentration squared. So that's 0.10 molar squared times Cl2 concentration, which is 0.1 molar. Now we can't forget to square that NO concentration, so that becomes 0.01 molar squared, and then that all simplifies to 3.0 molar to the minus 2 seconds to the minus 1. So altogether, this will be our rate law with the rate constant.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.